Om sir, today I will discuss transformation of sentences for class 10. Now, at first you must have to know what is the definition of transformation of sentences or what do you mean by transformation of sentences. Actually, the changing of the form of a sentence without changing its meaning is called transformation of sentences. This process is an excellent exercise as it teaches variety of expression in writing good English. So there are several methods. How do we interchange from one sentence to another sentence? Number one, we can change an interrogative sentence to an assertive sentence. What is the method? That means when the interrogative sentence is changed into an assertive form, then if the question is in the positive, then the answer will be in the negative. And in reverse process, you can say when the sentence is in the negative, the answer will be in the positive. This is one process. I can show you by giving one example. Suppose, what is the image of this statue? What is the use of this statue? This is an interrogative sentence. So you must have to transform this into an assertive form. What will be the answer? The answer will be, there is no use of this statue. There is no use of this statue. Now here you find that the sentence is in the affirmative form and here the answer is there is a negation, that means no use. But though the meaning is the same, but the form of the total two sentences are completely different. I think all of you understood this one. Next I go to process number 2. Now this is the method by which we can change from one exclamatory sentence to an assertive sentence. Now the course of the change from exclamatory to assertive sentences very usually used before an adjective and great before a noun. You must have to remember this one. Now let us take an example. Number one, what a fool you are. What a fool you are. Now this is an exclamatory sentence. You must have to change this exclamatory sentence into an assertive form. Answer is, you are a great fool. Here fool used as a noun. Here fool is used as a noun, that's why we put this noun great. It has been used. I think all of you have understood this one. The night is. This is an exclamatory sentence, so you must have to change this exclamatory sentence into an assertive form. third by changing its form. The night is very beautiful. The night is very beautiful. Now this is an adjective. As I have told you, the before adjective very is used only to show the intensity of the sentence. Now I will discuss the next method, number 3. Affirmative to negative. Affirmative to negative. Now this is the process which I am discussing now. Now a negative sentence is often formed by changing an assertive sentence into an interrogative or vice versa. Moreover, a negative form can be made by using opposite words such as none but, for only, never, forever, good, for bad, or by changing the degree of conversion or by using a clause like it is not that in this way. I am taking one example for this method. Can I ever forget you? Can I ever forget you? I can never forget you. Here we find that ever, it has been changed into never. So in this way, we also change from affirmative to negative. This sentence is particularly in the affirmative form, and this sentence is in the negative form. You can change from affirmative to negative. I am giving another example for this process. Suppose he is better than any other boy in the class. This is in the comparative. So you can change this comparative degree into a positive one by using this process. So no other boy. In the class. Is as good as he. This is positive. This transformation of sentences is